I had a couple of questions about local hire with respect to Site C. The minister, when he announced the Peace River Hydro Partners Civil Works contract on November 25th, 2015, he said, Honorable Speaker, at the time, and I'm quoting him, that 80% of workers on the Site C project are from British Columbia. You hear there's lots of Alberta license plates in that area. A lot of people who are working in the oil patch have now come over and they're working again living in BC. Right now, it's 80%. Except that, an FOI released last week by BC Hydro to the BC Building Trades Unions, it showed, as the minister was making that statement, the number was 65% and lower, Honorable Speaker, because in its statistics, BC Hydro tends to also use head office staff and so on. So that when the minister said declaratively on television, 80% of people here are from British Columbia, and the actual numbers at the time from BC Hydro, and these are their numbers, it's not ambiguous here, was 65%. Was he simply misinformed?
Minister?
Thank you, Honourable Chair. Well, we're just having a discussion here. The member is assuming, in fact, he stated as fact. I don't know how many times he stated as fact something today that's been inaccurate, but here's another example. Hydro, in fact, does not include its head office staff in the count. They don't include contractors' staff. They don't include the lawyers and the accountants and the surveyors in the count. So the member is wrong about that. The member says, was the minister misinformed? I don't think the minister was misinformed. I think the member was misinformed. And you know, the man is not here to defend himself, so I want to be respectful. You know, Mr. Sigurdsson came out with this announcement, if you will, that the number of BC workers on site was 65%. Mr. Sigurdsson had the information, as I understand it, to show what the actual number is averaged over a period of months. You know, every month is going to be different. He picked the month, it was November of 2015, where 65% of the workers on site were from British Columbia. And he went out and told the whole world, look at this, everybody's lying. BC Hydro, I think he named me by name. Yeah, I was actually quite hurt. By it, Honourable Chair. And he picked this month that had 65% Canadian workers on the site instead of, you know, he could have went August 2015 was 82%, September was 71%, October 71%. There's that November number, 65%. He liked that one because it was the lowest. December 67%. And then it starts to ramp up nicely. January 68%, February 71%, and the average was a little bit more than 70%. Honorable Speaker, or Honorable Chair, Hydro is keeping track of the number of British Columbia workers on the site, and it will vary from month to month. It'll ramp up a lot this spring with the main civil. There'll be hundreds of people coming onto the site, and Hydro and the Ministry will report out to the public on what the percentage of BC workers is at the Site C project. I'm just going to say one other thing about this, Honourable Chair, because I haven't had the opportunity to do this until now. The BC Building Trades actually received an enormous boost yesterday with the announcement made by Hydro and government on the turbines and generators contract. It will be BC Building Trades Unions who will get those jobs, and several of those unions attended the event yesterday. It was heartwarming, very gratifying for me, Honourable Chair, to see those unions there and to hear them commenting to the media after about how happy they were that the BC Building Trades had gotten so much work out of the Site C project. In fact, one of them even mentioned that he thought that the NDP was way off base in terms of his opposition to Site C, which I'm not sure the member had heard that, but I wanted to make sure he knew about it.
In the minister's enthusiasm for his last response, he accidentally, I'm sure, failed to answer the question. He expressed shock that Mr. Sigurdsson had chosen November because it was a month where there was only 65% BC workers, and he felt that was unfair by Mr. Sigurdsson to have chosen that date. But of course, it was in November that the minister himself said, right now, meaning November 2015, the very month that he referred to, right now about 80% of the people working at Site C are from British Columbia. And he just said a few minutes ago, right then, November 2015, the number was 65%. So I'm wondering, since the minister was clearly misinformed at the time, why did he make those statements everywhere? Why were they repeated by BC Hydro everywhere, including in their emailings out to everyone else, that the number was 80%? When it wasn't 80%, he just said it was 65%.
Minister.
Thank you, Honourable Chair. We went through this exercise yesterday on the mining file, where one of the members of the opposition was convinced that there was a conspiracy afoot, and there's no conspiracy afoot in terms of the numbers that we have for the average of the BC workers working on Site C. The November numbers obviously wouldn't come in, certainly not until very late in November, maybe not even until December was more likely. And what I was using was the latest number, latest average that had been provided to me by BC Hydro, which at that time was accurate. You know, we have an obligation to be accurate, and we will endeavor to get the latest information so that we can calculate whatever the average is. And make sure that we're putting out accurate information. But that information at that time, based on what had happened up to that point, was, as I understand it, quite accurate.
Member.
Well, the minister is, I guess, saying that the most recent information at that time was from July, because it wasn't anywhere near 80% in the months he was talking about. But he just said that the accurate information would have come in December. And yet, the president of BC Hydro said, I think just before Christmas, our count was 75 to 80%. And so if they got that information, they were still communicating the minister's message at that point, a message, by the way, that he never corrected. So in effect, Honourable Speaker, when he said right now, he was wrong. And nothing wrong with being wrong, but when you use that line as a club in a political debate, and you're and found out by your own material to be completely wrong, and then your supporters then repeat that message repeatedly, I think that's a bit of a problem.